Amen. Praise the Lord. Shall we give a mighty hand of praise before Jesus? Hallelujah. Gwapo kayo kay nagtapok na punta karon that we are talking about the goodness of God, that we are talking about unsa ba ka maayo si Jesus sa atong kinabuhi, kung unsa kiunsa niya ta pagbag-o, how he gave us a new perspective. So I would like to greet everyone, even paman sa mga nagtanaw sa live. Praise the Lord. It is not an accident that you are watching this today. Even paman sa mga nagapam karon, it is not an accident that you are sitting here today. O karong gabi una, ang atong pagahisgutan is beauty that outlasts looks. As mga babae, mostly naga-focus ta sa atong outward appearance. As mga babae, usually naga-focus ta sa atong makita. And before we begin sa kanina preaching, I would like to start off with saying this: a wise woman puts God first. Women of God can never be like women of the world. The Bible says in Psalm 46 verse 5, God is within her. She will not fall. God will help her at the break of day. Because Jesus went to the cross and died for the sins of the world. On the cross, he took all of our sins and laid them on him, so that while he was on the cross, he bore your sins and my sins. Nga katong naa si Jesus sa cross, ako man unta ang angayan ditua, bantog na sairan ako, nga unsa man kadako ang akong sala. Pag-abot ni Jesus dito sa cross, ang tanan akong sala gipasan, giangkon niya ang akong mga sala. They buried him, yet he resurrected from the dead. And this is the same Jesus who saved me. Bantog, women of the world can never be like women of God, and women of God can never be like women of the world. Because when we encountered Jesus, when we encountered that love, when we encountered na katong gugma nga mao ni bag-o sa atoa, katong visitation that changed us, that changed our perspective. He gave us a new perspective. He gave us a new point of view, an identity in Christ. Nga dili na ko mag-focus sa butang aning kalibutana. Nga dili na ko mag-focus sa mga butang nga makita. He gave me a new identity, a new purpose. Nga dili na ko magsigig pangita sa mga butang aning kalibutana. Dili na ko muadto sa Facebook. Dili na ko muadto sa social media to find my worth. Because when I encountered Jesus on that cross, that is more than enough for me. Nga dili na ko mag-seek sa love sa tao, because love pa lang ni Jesus, puno na ko. Dili na ko mag-seek sa applause sa tao, because ang pag-ingon pa lang ni Jesus na well done, good and faithful servant, puno na ko. When I encounter Jesus, pagkahibalo na to nga si Jesus, he was on that cross with those nail-pierced hands sa cross. Nirepenta sa atong mga sala, hinusuli ang inyong mga sala. Matthew 3:2, repent of your sins, for the kingdom of God is near. When we repented of our sins, when we encountered Jesus, he changed our name. Just like Jacob, he changed who Jacob was into Israel. He changed who we are. He changed our mindset. He changed our lives to be less of the world and more like him. And when I encounter Jesus, when we encounter Jesus, there's a new perspective, a new identity. And I would focus on who I am in the sight of the Lord rather than who I am in the sight of men. Because what could profit the world if what could profit a man if he gains the whole world yet forfeit his own soul? People of the world focus on the opinion of men, but people in God focus on the word of the Lord. 2 Corinthians 4:18 says, so we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. But pasabot na sukad nga na-encounter na ako si Jesus, wala na ko nag-focus sa butang nga mahanaw lang. Wala na ko nag-focus sa physical, but nag-focus ko sa akong spiritual walk kay Jesus. That wealth, vanity, I'm sorry, those are not for me. But as for me, I will fix my eyes on what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, and what is unseen is eternal. Nga mo-focus ko sa akong pagpangalagad, mo-focus ko sa akong pag-serve, mo-focus ko sa akong relasyon sa Ginoo. And let us all become beautiful with a kind of beauty that never passes. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Bible says in 1 Peter 3:3-4, don't be concerned about the outward appearance. Don't be concerned about the outward beauty of fancy hairstyles, expensive jewelry, or beautiful clothes. You should clothe yourselves instead with a beauty that comes from within. the unfading beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is so precious to God. The Bible says, don't be concerned about the outward beauty of fancy hairstyles, expensive jewelry, or beautiful clothes. You should clothe yourselves instead with the beauty that comes from within you. Beauty nga dili puro physical, but beauty that comes from within you. The heart, a woman after God's own heart. You see, God is not against beauty. Dili man against ang ginoo sa beauty. Kung tahanan mo nga, bawal na di ay nga mualaga sa sarili, bawal na di ay nga alagaan ang physical nga being, ang physical appearance, bawal na di ay alagaan. God is not against beauty. He is against sensuality. Esther, Rachel, Sarah were beautiful women, and the Bible says nga beautiful sila. Si Esther, in the book of Esther 2:7, kung mabasa na ninyo, pampered kaayo si Esther. She was such a beautiful woman na one of the most pampered people in the Bible. Si Esther, siguro kay naay naga make up sa iyaha, naay naga pasuot sa iyahag mga sanina. And God is not against beauty. God is not against beauty. He is against sensuality. And you know, we were made in the image of God, meaning that we reflect His beauty. Gina-reflect na to ang beauty sa Ginoo. So once again, God is not against beauty. Nga mag-ayos ka, magtarong kag sanina, magtarong ka sa imong naong, sa imong buhok. God is not against beauty, but He is against sensuality. It doesn't mean that it is wrong to give any attention to your hair. It doesn't mean that it's wrong to wear earrings. It doesn't mean that it's wrong to take care of yourself physically. But you know, if that is the center of your life, if it's overboard, if it's exaggerated, makasala na ka. Because God is not against beauty, He is against sensuality. When you see it, you know it, makabalo ka. There is a difference between beauty and sensuality. The way you carry, the way you present yourself as a woman doesn't reflect God. Makabalo ka sa imong pag-present sa imong sarili. Kabalo ka sa imong pagpanginabuhi. Kung gina-represent ba nimo, kung gina-reflect ba nimo ang Ginoo, or kung gina-reflect nimo ang beauty standards sa kalibutan. The way that you carry out, the way that you present yourself, you would know if that is beauty that comes from within, beauty that comes from God, or sensuality, or the pleasures and desires, or luho niining kalibutana. We were made in the image of God, but we were also made in His likeness too. The Bible says, Genesis 1:26, and God said, let us make man in our image after our likeness. But pasabot, yes, you were made in His image, and yes, you are beautiful. But if kung dira lang taman sa physical ang imong kagwapa, kung sa physical lang ang imong beauty, the Bible says God made us in His image and in His likeness. But pasabot that we ought to be like Him. We ought to show who God is in the way we live, in the way we dress, in the way we speak, in the way we present ourselves. We ought to reflect God. We ought to reflect His likeness, because He is the creation and He is the creator, and we are the creation. He is the potter and we are the clay. But pasabot that as paintings, we need to reflect the painter, and that is God. And you would know kung ang imong pagpresent sa imong sarili, you would know kung ang imong pagbarog sa imong kaugalingon iya ba sa kalibutan, or para ba sa Ginoo ang imong ginabuhat. The Bible clearly states na walay problema in beauty. There's no problem in beauty. There is a problem in vanity, in sensuality, na dira magsentro ang imong kinabuhi. Dressing in ways to fit in the standards of the world. And I know, daghan kaayog masuko ani that let women dress how they want to dress, but the Bible says women should dress modestly, because your body is the temple. Even if it breaks the law of Christ, buhaton siya po nimo ang standards sa world, buhaton siya po nimo ang beauty standards sa kalibutan. Even if it breaks the law of Christ, even kids, even teenagers, even young adults. And that is really, really wrong. The Bible says that God doesn't focus on outward appearance. It is what's on the inside that matters most to Him. Bible says in 1 Samuel 16:7, but the Lord said to Samuel, do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. The Lord does not look at the things people look at. People look at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. Kadalasan sa tuwa mo tanaw, hala, guwapa diri sa tubangan. Hala, dato tanawon kani akong amiguhon. But the Lord doesn't pick that way. The Lord doesn't choose that way. He looks at your heart. Kay daghag mga guwapa, daghag mga guwapo. Pero ang kasing-kasing garbo, ang kasing-kasing puno sa sala. And if ever you're sitting down and if ever you're watching this today na nagpadayon japong ka sa kangit-ngit, nagpadayon japong ka sa pagpakasala, the Bible says, repent for the kingdom of God is near. Dili pwede nga, dili tamang hinulsol tungod kay pinaagi lamang sa paghinulsol nga si Jesus mo, abot ka na to. Because if you are still holding on to your pride, then you can never see the Lord. You can never encounter the Lord. And remember, God doesn't focus on our outward appearance. He looks at the heart. He looks at your heart. He looks at your heart. Daghan diri, especially women, mag-face, especially mga batanon, if there are young people watching this today. A lot of us feel insecure by the way we look, by our bodies, by our facial features. But remember, the beauty is not just measured by your physical appearance, but it is measured by your devotion, by your relationship, by your heart of surrender to God. It matters in your heart. Heart na dili lang kalibutanon nga pagkabinuotan, but holiness, that you live out holiness, you live out the Word of God, that you live out Jesus in your life, that Jesus is the center of your life, and that is true beauty, and that is the true definition of beautiful. As women of God, we need to yield these following words. Sabi ni Saya, as mighty women of God, kinahanglan na mauni ang mga pulo nga atong barugan. Modesty, wisdom, beauty, elegance, dignity, and strength, and refinement. As women, we need to be modest. We need to be full of wisdom. We need to have elegance. We need to have dignity. We need to have strength. We need to have refinement. We need to yield these words, and not sensuality, not extravagance, not luho, but we need to yield modesty, wisdom, beauty, elegance, dignity, strength, refinement, and there is nothing more attractive than a woman who has this. There is nothing more attractive than the woman who cares for the orphans. There is nothing more attractive than a woman who cares for the widow. Sama kay Ruth. There is nothing more attractive than a woman who serves the Lord, than a woman who puts God first, than a woman who serves the Lord with enthusiasm, with love, than a woman who makes friends with people who are undeserving and preaches to them about the good news of Christ, that repent, kay naay gugma ang Ginoo. There is nothing more attractive and there is nothing more beautiful than a woman who has this, because 1 Timothy 2:10 says, for women who claim to be devoted to God should make themselves attractive by the good things they do. By the good things you do. If you claim that you are devoted to the Lord, make yourself attractive by worship. Make yourself attractive through helping people in need. Make yourself attractive by visiting people in prison, by caring for the orphans, caring for the widows. Make yourself attractive by staying away from sin. Make yourself attractive by having dignity. Make yourself attractive by having a relationship in Christ, by having an intimate relationship with the Lord, that you would live out His Word. You would live out whatever is written in the Bible, that when people see you, they would see beyond the physical beauty. But when people see you, they would see the fruits of the Spirit. They would see Christ, and there is nothing more attractive than a woman who has this. 1 Timothy 2:10 once again, for women who claim to be devoted to God, make themselves attractive by the good things they do. That is the true definition of beauty. Beauty in the heart, beauty in their service towards the Lord, and not in the service towards men. so focused on what you see in the mirror. Sometimes as mga babae ba, focus kayta sa atong makita sa salamin. We are so focused on what we see in the mirror, but are we aware of what we mirror? Focus kaayo sa imong makita sa salamin. Apa, nahibal-an ba nimo kung unsa ang imong ginasalamin? The Bible says in Proverbs 27:19, as face is reflected in water, so the heart reflects the real person. So if your heart is full of anger, if your heart is full of bitterness, then you, imong pagkatao, bully ka, maldita ka, sige kag pangaway. Kung ang imong heart full of jealousy, sige kag panlibak. And if your beauty mulimit lang sa imong physical, and your heart is dirty, your heart is full of greed, anger, hatred, lust, then that beauty won't matter. Because the Lord doesn't look at your outward appearance, but He looks at the heart. Are you more focused on your weight? Are you more focused on your clothes or makeup than you are of God? Because the Bible tells us to look closer to our hearts and actions rather than our presentation and appearance. Psalms 51 verse 10 says, create in me a clean heart, O God. Renew a loyal spirit within me. Once again, there's nothing wrong. Nothing wrong kung mag-ayos ka sa imong kaugalingon. Because our God is holy. O gusto ta, limpyo ta. Limpyo ang atong physical being. But if you are way too focused on what you look like, way too focused on your physical nga anyo sa imong physical appearance, then the Bible tells us to look closer to our hearts. Basin focus hay ka sa imong makita sa salamin. Patang himong kasing-kasing. Do you focus on what your heart reflects? Because the heart reflects the person. If the kung a mirror mo reflect lang sa naong, but ang kasing-kasing mo reflect gayud sa pagkatao. There is no problem in physical attractiveness. Once again, kay daghan kayo babae sa Bible, Jude, nga giingnan nga guwapa, sama kay Sarah, sama kay Rachel, sama kay Esther. Those are beautiful women. But remember, if puno japong ka sa sala, if nanginabuhi japong ka sa kangit-ngit, if you're still holding on to sin, if your heart is still full of envy, if your heart is still kanang maldita, sige japong pangaway kung ang imong kasing-kasing puno japon sa kangit-ngit, then how about the heart? Clothing, check, guwapo kayo. Buhok, check, salapid pa. Arios, check, naa. Mga alahas, naa. Pero ang kasing-kasing, ang kasing-kasing, kibiyaan na ba ang sala? Kibiyaan na ba ang pagkaselos? Kibiyaan na ba ang pagkalibakera? Umaw na yung common, labi na sa mga babae. Gossiping, jealousy, envy, vanity. How about the heart? Pwede nga bago ang imong sanina, putli ang imong pisikal nga sanina, pero ang imong kasing-kasing hugaw pa sa lapok. That's why we need to focus on what is in the heart rather than what we see. Remember, pwede nga daghan kay kaguyab, pwede nga daghan kag followers, kay guwapa ka, but if your heart is bad, that beauty won't matter because charm is deceptive and beauty does not last, but a woman who fears the Lord will be greatly praised. Remember, the woman in the well, pila ka buok, ang iyahang na partner, but wala japon siya na tagbaw, but when she encountered the Lord, gibiyaan niya. Huwag niingon siya, nakikabalo na kong kinsa ang misaya kay ang beauty. Kung pila ba na imong uyab, pila ba na ang imong naasawa, pila ba ang imong followers, pila ba ang imong amigo, dili mo na madala sa tubangan sa atong buhi nga Dios. Dili mo na sila madala. Kung when you're face to face with the Lord on judgment day, and remember, kani atong physical, it would pass. Daghan kay guwapa nga mga babae nga, it would pass. Daghan kay guwapa nga mga artists, young people, celebrities, but we all end up in the grave. From dust we come from, and from dust we shall return. And if your beauty limitado lang sa imong physical, limitado lang sa makita, then that beauty would go in the grave with your bones, with your flesh. Because this is not forever. But kabalo ka, unsay forever? Imong heart, nag-surrender ni mo kay Jesus, imong gibuhat para kay Jesus, naka-record sa books, the book of Psalms said, I forgot the verse, but the book of Psalms said na every day of my life is recorded in your book. But pasabot na kung ni-invest ka sa pagpangalagad, ni-invest ka sa pag-serve kay Jesus, ni-invest ka sa beauty of the heart, beauty that comes from within, beauty that will never pass. Kana nga beauty nga imong kipakita nakasulat sa libro sa Ginoo, nakasulat forever to, unlike the beauty that is physical that would soon pass and would soon wither away. The Bible clearly says na we should focus on what is in the heart. Because the Lord looks at the heart. Dili nimo mapresenta sa Ginoo, Lord, guwapa man ko. Lord, daghan man ko amigo. Lord, daghan man ko compliments. But the Lord looks at the heart. Doesn't matter how beautiful you are when your heart is ugly. It doesn't matter. And a woman can and should be beautiful. Don't get me wrong. A woman can and should be beautiful because God designed her to be that way. Us as women, we are designed to be beautiful because we image and we are made in the likeness of God. However, the physical side of beauty is just a small part of what makes a woman truly beautiful. Don't let your adorning be external, but let your beauty shine from within. Ayaw sugot na ang imong kagandahan. Ayaw sugot that your beauty would just be limited to what people see. But make sure that it is what God sees. And kadalasan, we are so focused on our outward appearance, so focused on what we see. How about your heart? Are you focused na anakay na pasakitan? Na anakay na pasagdan? Imong mama, wala na siguro yung nakaon, wala di mo gialagaan. Imong amigo, isa na lang siguro, isa, pero wala man lang di mo nasangyawan tungod kay focus kay ka sa makita. Focus kaayo ka sa imong like sa Facebook. Focus kaayo ka sa imong mga uyab. Pero ang Ginoo, did you give attention to the Word of God? Did you give attention to His commandments? Remember, the physical side of beauty is just a small part of what makes a woman truly beautiful. Remember Psalms 144 verse 4, I think, na their days are just like a passing shadow. All of us, niagi tag pagkabata. Niagi ta na una palang tagi anak. First day nga gianak ta, some here kadalasan diri gianak 2000s, 1990s, 1980s. But sa isa kapiyungan na ana ta diri karon, pila na ang atong edad. Niagi na ta sa atong pagka-cute, sa atong pagkabata. Nayuban diri niagi na sa ilang pagkabataon. Naanay uban diri na even people watching, naanay uban diri na naa na silang old age. And that is how beauty quickly passes and beauty quickly fades. But when you serve the Lord, kung naa kay gitabangan, gipreacha nimo about kay Jesus, sure ko ang imong gitabangan wa to kalimot sa imong gibuhat. Pero ang imong physical na anyo, kutob na lang sa picture. But the heart, ang service towards the Lord, that would last forever. Remember 1 Peter 3:4, rather it should be that of your inner self, the unfading beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is of great worth in God's sight. Heart ba? Beauty, inner beauty, which is beautiful in God's sight. Are you happy with those who are happy? Do you weep with those who weep? Romans 12:15. Kay basin lipay ka sa kapildihan sa uban, basin goal ka sa kadaugan sa uban, when in fact the Bible says love your neighbor, love your enemy as you love yourself. Is that beauty within you? Do you have this heart, sama sa Luke 3:11, na if you have two shirts, give one to the poor. If you have food, share it with those who are hungry. Or basin dalo, giapon ka. Kaya kung guwapa ka, pero dalo lagi ka, dili lagi na magmatter sa atubangan sa Ginoo. Luke 3:11, for even the Son of Man, the Bible says, even the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve. Kung ang imong heart kutob lang nga ay gwapo man ko gwapo kog kamot dili dapat ni mapaslutan. But the Bible clearly says that we should serve. We should serve, and that beauty that comes from within should shine. Let your light so shine before men. Let your light shine before the world. That inner beauty, that beauty that you have would not reflect yourself, but would reflect Christ that dwells inside of you. And a physically attractive woman is one who dresses modestly. Modest kapag dress, dili sexy nga pag dress, dili very showy sa skin na pag dress. The Bible says 1 Corinthians 6:20, for God bought you with a high price, so you must honor God with your body. I know a lot of people will be mad, labi na mga batanon, kabalo ko nga, daghag masuko ani nga, let women dress the way they dress. Daghan kayong nga protesta ani. But the Bible says, God bought you with a high price, so you must honor God with your body. Kay kani atong body, mauni mismo ang gipakamatyan sa atong buhi nga Dios. Kani nga body, mauni ang reason why God became flesh. Because if He was a spirit, He couldn't save flesh beings like us. That's why God became flesh, the Word became flesh to bear the death, because death was proof that God, that Jesus was man, but resurrection was proof that Jesus was God. And we must honor God with our bodies. Social media, TikTok, ano, mga sayaw, nga laway, kaayo, social media, mga sayaw, mga sinuotan, nga dili, maayo, magkimbot-kimbot, magkiay-kiay sa social media, abi ninyo, baka pahimaya na sa atubangan, sa Ginoo. Pero what God is thinking, mauni akong gipakamatyan. Nganong you are not respecting the temple of the Lord. Dress modestly. Even children nowadays, mga bata pa lang ang ako'y nakita sa social media nga, bata pa lang kaayo ang ginapasuot na, dili na maayo. And train up a child in the way he should go, and when he's old, he shall not depart from it. Lamentations, the book of Lamentations says, we should dress modestly. The problem is, even baman sa sulod sa church, gihimo nang fashion show ang simbahan, when in fact, it is a heart nga show ang pangit og sanina, dili ba atun sa tubangan ni palikod, na sa Book of James, masuko ang Ginoo sa imuha. Ang church gihimo nang fashion show, pagwapuhay sa sanina, pamubuay sa palda, kay naay mga cute na mga lalaki sa youth. Gihimo ninyong gidefile ninyo ang temple sa Ginoo. This is a holy place where hearts are supposed to surrender, where hearts are supposed to be healed, where families are supposed to be restored. Kinadefile ninyo, pinaagi lang sa pagsuot ng mga malaway, sa mali nga mga motibo. And that is the problem nowadays. That is why the church, they don't reflect Christ anymore. And you are the church. Mayroon ka wala man ko sa simbahan. Nga no magtarong mangkog sanina. Tungkol kay ikaw ang simbahan. And it is not just a place, but it is you. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. So we must dress modestly. And when you think of the women ba, kung mag-isip mo mga babae, even us, when you think of the women that you hold in high regard, kanang mga respeto kay ni mga babae ba, kanang ganing ginarespeto, gina-honor dyan yung mga babae. Wala ni mo ginagtanaw ilang physical na being. Kung isipon ni mo mga babae nga gina-honor ni mo, there are usually ladies who are kind, ladies who are gentle, women who are thoughtful, unselfish. Mauna ang imong gina-put in high regard, nga gina-honor ni mo, kumbaga ba gina-respect ni mo, wala ka, hala kuyawan niya on, kay butan siya, kay selfless siya, dili siya selfish. Usually, that is what people remembers nga hala, maubiya niyang nitahabang sa kuwa. And remember, Proverbs 11:16, a gracious woman gains respect. Sige ra kag pagwapa, sige ra kag pagwapa, pero patulan lang nimo bisag kinsa. Sige ra kag pagwapa, pero libakon ra nimo bisag kinsa. A gracious woman gains respect. Bisag unsaon nimo try nga respetuon ka sa tao, di ka marespeto tungod kay kutob lang diha. We need to be gracious. We need to reflect the Lord. Remember, she is not only your, we should not only be attractive, but we should gain honor and respect from those who see her, not just because of clothing, but because we are clothed with strength and dignity. Usbon ako, we should not gain respect, we should not gain honor just because of our clothing, just because of our physical clothing, but because we are clothed in strength and dignity. Proverbs 31:25, she is clothed with strength and dignity. She laughs without a fear of the future. Our clothing, dili ka nang mubo. Our clothing should be strength and dignity. Our clothing, dili ka nang sexy. Kinahanglan, helmet of salvation, breastplate of righteousness, shield of faith, sword of the spirit, belt of truth, shoes of the gospel of peace, nga anda mangulata sa kaaway, anda mangulata sa mga demons, anda mo barog para kay Kristo. We need to be women that focus on our relationship with God rather than focusing on what we look like to men. How a woman looks to God is more important than any quality she possesses, because one day her outer beauty will fade and her inner beauty will cease. And her outer beauty will cease. But the beauty that God sees in her will be important when she stands before Him. Being beautiful to God should be top priority on every woman's list. Kung beautiful ka sa tao, pero muatubang ka sa Ginoo, ang imong kasing-kasing dili maayo, ang iyang ingon pahawa, wala ko kaila sa imuha. And not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord will be saved. Being beautiful before God is more important than being beautiful before men. Palakpak lang sa tao, that's all you're ever gonna get. Only claps of men. Ngayon, guwapahan ni mo, oy, kuyawan ni mo, ano, you're very beautiful, but that's all you're gonna get, I'm telling you. Mao lang na ang imong makuha, palakpak lang sa tao, pero pagatubang ni mo sa Ginoo, nga ang imong kasing-kasing, dili maayo ang iyang ingon sa imo, wala ko kaila sa imuha. Tungod kay, we need to focus on being beautiful before God. Forgive those who sinned against you. Honor your father and mother. If someone is hungry, feed them. If your enemy is hungry, feed them. And that is what we need. Being beautiful to God should be our top priority. Being beautiful before God should be our main focus. Not just our weight, not just our makeup, not just our clothes, but being beautiful inside and out. Glory sa Ginoo, that we would reflect His glory, that because of the beauty that comes from within, muapaw siya, muahawas siya, nga mureflect siya sa imong gawas nga beauty na matingala sila, na lahi na lagi siya, bago na lagi ni siya, dili na lagi siya pareha sa una, tungod kay ang imuhang tinuod nga beauty, wala na nimo gikuha sa makeup, wala na nimo gikuha sa mga cosmetics, wala na nimo gikuha sa mga ariyos, sa mga necklace, sa accessories, but ang imong beauty gikuha na nimo sa glory sa Ginoo, natagamtaman na nimo sa iyahang pagkamaayo sa imong relasyon kaniya. And I believe that is the true meaning of beauty. The Bible says, Ephesians 4:24, put on your new nature, created to be like God, truly righteous and holy. To be truly beautiful, we need to be holy. To be truly beautiful, we need to live a righteous life. To be truly beautiful, we need to let our light shine, and not just puros vanity, adlaw-adlaw ili sa profile picture, pagdaghan pa jug heart, mura na siyag nakadaog sa lute. True beauty that comes from within. Beauty that God gives you. Kay kana nga beauty, dili makawat sa tao. Kung beauty lang ka sa physical, samad lang ka, wala na. Pero beauty that comes from within, beauty that comes from serving the Lord, it's a different level. Different level. O gayaw, gingon na pampered man kay ka, di ka gamitin sa Ginoo. Well, Esther was pampered, pero gigamit siya maayos sa Ginoo. And I believe that there would be women who would preach, women that would speak out about the goodness of God, women focusing on the Word of God, women focusing on what is unseen rather than on what is seen. We need to have dignity. We need to have strength. We need to have qualities and traits like Jesus. The Bible says, for those who claim to be devoted to God should live their lives as Jesus did. And that is a way to be beautiful. Once again, caring for the orphans, caring for the widows. Kung naa kay sanina, naa'y walay sanina, saninaan nimo. Naa kay pagkaon, naa'y gigutom, pakauno nimo. Walay pamasahe ang imong amigo, naa kay gamay, ihatag nimo kay kabalukang amas kinahanglan niya. Naa'y nanginahanglan tabangan nimo, naa'y nanginahanglan og tabang. Naa'y nanginahanglan og advice, gakso nimo. Naa'y lonely, ubanan nimo. Nanang tinuod na beauty. Dili beauty nga tanaw nimo na ikaw na ang taas sa tanan tungod kay gwapa ka, tungod kay beautiful ka physically. But remember that our heart is what matters the most. Remember Proverbs 11:22. Una na kong dungog ani nga verse, nakatawa jud ko. A beautiful woman who lacks discretion is like a gold ring in a pig's snout. Sana, ang babaeng agwapa, pero pangit ang mga desisyon, mura nagbaboy nga naisingsing sayang ilong. Inana, ang mga babae na puros lang pagwapa, pero ang kasing-kasing pangit ay mura nagbaboy nga naisingsing sa imong ilong, walay atik. Inana, ang pananaw sa Ginoo sa imuha, puros lang kapagwapa, sige lang pisikal, pero ang imong kasing-kasing di ay baboy nga naisingsing sa imong ilong. Physical attractiveness, physical beauty, but if libakera, selosa, dumtanon, dili mo tabang sa mga naglisod, mangkasarili. A beautiful woman who lacks discretion is like a gold ring in a pig's snout. Proverbs 11:22. Naadyot ni sa Bible. Puros lang kapagwapa. Puros lang kapataas sa imong kaugalingon. Igsoon, dili lang dira kutob ang tinuod nga beauty. True beauty isn't limited to what we see, but to what God sees. Kay kung unsa ang makita sa Ginoo, maudyot na ang tinuod nga makapahimaya kaniya. Maudyod na kang tinuhon. Ay pwede nga gwapa ka karon, pero pag abot sa imong katigulangon, mawala lagi ng tanan. Mawala na. And in the short time that we are on earth, 70 years, if more, maybe 80. If more, maybe 80 years. That beauty would fade. But your works, your acts of surrender towards the Lord, maunang iyang mahinumduman. And the Bible says, Luke 1:45, you are blessed because you believe that the Lord would do what He said. Or in NIV, blessed is she who believes that the Lord would fulfill His promises to her. Kita ang blessed ba? That we believe the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11, kabalo lagi ko, nga na ako'y hope, na ako'y future, nga dili lang ko dirikutob, dili lang kutob sa physical, but kabalo ko that my labor is not in vain. Kabalo ko, Lord, nga na ang kay promise ako. Kabalo ko, Lord, that I have a mansion. Kabalo ko, Lord, in your words, I believe every promise that you have spoken, that you are the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Nga just like Caleb ba, maskin dugay siya nag hulat, pero hulaton dyan na ako ang promise sa Ginoo. 40 kapin nga years na ako giulat ang iyang promise, but I am still standing strong. I would still wait on His word. I will still wait on His promise. And that's why I said in the beginning nga women in Christ could never be like women of the world. Kaya nga, ano, bago naman na itong perspective, bago naman na itong heart, sa una lagi gusto ta nga mag-TikTok para daghag likes, daghag followers, ta TikTok pagwapa high, pag naong, pa sexy high, pagsanina, but karon paupsanay nagkasing-kasing atubangan sa Ginoo. Kay mao na ang tinuod nga beauty. Kung tanaw man sa kalibutan nga mura natag naon sa ano, mag-preach man ka, nganong inala man ka, dapat mag-beauty queen ka, kay imong lawas sayang, imong naong sayang. But sorry, I would reflect the beauty of Christ, not the beauty of the world, because we are given a new perspective. Sorry, di na ako kinahanglan mo apilo beauty contest para ingnan nga gwapa ko, because akong identity wala sa beauty contest, wala sa kalibutan. Ang akong identity naa kay Kristo, ug hamili niyang dugo ang mao inibayad sa kuha. And for me, that is more than enough. That is more than enough sa clap sa men. That is more than enough sa comments sa mga tao na pretty, gwapa. What matters to me the most is ingnan ko sa Ginoo na well done, good and faithful servant. And once again, balik ko now, there's no problem in being beautiful. There's no problem in wearing earrings. There's no problem in dressing up nicely. But you know your limitations. You know when beauty is turned into vanity. You know when things get overboard. And that kana ang atong bantayunon. Nga permi na lang imong kinaisip imong kaugalingon. Permi na lang imong kinaisip nga guwapa sa gawas, guwapa sa gawas, guwapa sa gawas. Pero wa na nimo ati manang imong sulod. Sulod that as water reflects the face, so as the heart reflects the person. So focused on water, so focused on mirrors, so focused on cell phones, on selfies, on social media. But are you focused on your heart? What does your heart reflect? Kamo rin na kabaluana. O kung unsa ang ma-reflect sa imong heart, unsa isulod sa imong heart, maka-affect sa people around you. Because if imong heart puno sa greed, naglisod imong mama, dili nimo tabangan. O ginana, guwapa lang ka sa gawas, pero di man lang nimo tabangan ang mga naglisod. That is not what true beauty is. So now we need to focus on what does our heart reflect? Unsa ba ang na-reflect sa atong kasing-kasing? Kay kung unsang imong pagkatao, mauna ang sulod sa imong heart. And if kung sulod sa imong heart si Jesus, tingala ka arte man kay ni sa unang anong karon mo kamang na maglapok para musturya sa mga taga-bukid. Dili man ni magpatarog sa una, pero nganong karon tabangan naman ang mga naglisod. Nung kinay bagong kasing-kasing, bagong perspective, bagong nga heart nga gihatag ni Jesus ug mauni ang tinuod na beauty na dili jud makadaog ang standard sa kalibutan, dili jud makadaog ang mga storya sa kalibutan tungod kay beauty ni na ang Ginoo na jud mismo ang nag-ingon nga mauni ang iyang ginapangita, just like David nga ayaw focus lagi sa outward appearance kay mauna ang ginatanaw sa tao, pero ang Ginoo wala lang nagtanaw dito, nagtanaw siya sa imong kasing-kasing na willing mo repent, kasing-kasing na Lord gamit ako, kasing-kasing na Jesus dili ko gusto na masama sa kalibutan, but gusto ko Lord nga mahimong kahayag, for our citizenship is in heaven. And as we serve the Lord, before we end this preaching, short preaching about beauty that comes from within or beauty nga dili jud mo pass, I encourage everyone that there is beauty that outlasts looks. That is beauty in the heart, beauty in serving the Lord, beauty in loving Jesus. Muingon man nga na batanan pa man ko, naman ko'y looks, naman ko'y figure sa body. Well, I'm telling you, kana nga posisyon, kana na name, kana na fame, that won't matter in front of the Lord. What matters is your heart. For dust you came, and to dust you shall return. So I'm not saying that we should not be beautiful. In fact, we need to be beautiful. We need to show ourselves and present ourselves presentable. Tarong dapat ang buhok, dili dapat, humot dapat. But, if dira lang limitado, ang imong beauty, then that is not what God wants. He wants us to focus on our hearts rather than focusing on our appearance. And as women of the Lord, I believe that we could all be beautiful. We could all have that beauty that will never pass. Okay, God is generous. He could do for you what He did for me. He could do for others what He did for us. And that is why we need to reflect that beauty. Because if people see us, they would no longer see us, but they would see Christ. And if they would see Christ, makutanan sila nga nung nabago naman ka. Maka-preach dahin ka, maka-share dahin ka, makaingon dahin ka na pwede kayo nga mabago ka, kaya-kaya na mabago ang imong perspektibo, kay baguhon ka ni Jesus, higugmaon ka ni Jesus. And I would like to end this with saying, di jud pwede nga di tamang hinulsol. I would like to end this with saying, repent, for the kingdom of God is near. If any of you are still wearing sexy clothes, are still listening to worldly music, are still practicing homosexuality or drinking alcohol or going to parties or worshiping idols, repent, for the kingdom of God is near. And you would call me killjoy, but no. That is what the Bible says. That is what the word of the Lord says. And the problem is, the sin has been so normalized that when someone lies have been so normalized that when someone tells the truth, masuko na ang mga tao. That I'm here to tell the truth because I love you. Repent, for the kingdom of God is near, and don't focus on what you see, but focus on what God sees. That is all. Taga na tagkusog na palakpak ang atong buhi nga Dios.